Hey guys, so welcome back to my channel. It's so funny, every time I do my editing and then I play everything and when I'm like, hey guys, welcome back to my channel, I always feel like I sound so freaking annoying. Like, hey guys, welcome back to my channel. Like, and so then I end up mocking myself like the entire time while I'm editing my video. Anyways, so for real though, welcome back. So today's video is actually in regards to my new hair color. As stated before, you know, I do like to change my hair color a lot. And the last color I had, as you guys could see from the previous videos, was the hot pink. And I literally did that one last minute, literally a week before my wedding. I was like, I don't want to be blonde for my wedding. I want to have a color because that's who I am. So it kind of, I was itching so bad. I had went almost a year without any fun colors in my hair because I wanted my hair to be like the perfect blonde for my wedding. And then I went and dyed it pink. So anyways, well, I'm going to kind of give you guys, before you guys actually see the process of how I did it, I'm actually going to go over what I did and then you guys can see what I actually did and how I parted my hair, which it's really not that serious, but you can actually see the transformation. I had a very, very pale pink blonde. A lot of it was really, really blonde, but then I had still some pink in there, not as bright as my other videos. So what I used was Ion Brilliance, and these colors you can actually get at Sally's Beauty. I wanted to also use a color that you guys can kind of get your hands on and be able to use. I actually used Ion Brilliance for my pink as well. So maybe if I go back to pink, I can also do a video for you guys on how I achieved that like perfect pink color. It was so amazing. Anyways, as you could see, I'm gonna show you a picture really quick. See, it was perfect. Anyways, so I've been kind of like dying to do this blue. Prior to this, I've been every color. I've been red, I've done half purple, half pink, half blue, half green. Then I did like an ombre with like my roots pink and then the rest purple, or purple and pink. I don't know, I've been every color. Anyways, so this time I wanted to do blue, and this color is called Blue Jean. This is literally after I colored it. I haven't washed it yet. I'm literally on day two of having this hair color. This is my hair after work. It's like kind of a little dead a little bit, but you know, I live in Florida, so it gets like really, really hot. Just walking to your car, you feel like you just crossed the Sahara Desert. So, all right, so these are the colors that I used to achieve this. Now, I started off with titanium. Then shark blue. And then I was gonna do azure in a different, no, I was gonna make, I mixed them all together. This is what happened. So I mixed all of these together. First of all, when I opened this one, it was white. So I'm like, maybe it will actually oxidize once it's mixed with the other colors, whatever. Now, it was a dupe. Like, it was completely filled with completely clear color, which was turned into a mission. But I used the titanium, and all three, well, this was not even a color. So this one in titanium, so shark blue and titanium, and I actually mixed those together. Well, the titanium actually just completely took over the entire color. So this one didn't even take, so I pretty much wasted my money. So this one had no color in it. And then once I put titanium with this one, it actually completely absorbed all the color and it was just gray. So I sent my husband on a trip to Sally's while I looked like a crazy person and just decided to clean my bathroom while I was waiting. So he ended up returning the one that was wrong, popped it open before he left, and it's actually supposed to be like a lighter blue. So I was like, screw it, I don't want titanium. So I ended up mixing shark blue and azure together. And when I mix those two together, this is the color that it came out. What I did was I started off from my nape and I went all the way up. And as you can see, I have dark, but that's actually my regrowth from my pink hair. So I felt like the blue and my dark roots would actually mix really, really well. So I left my roots dark instead of completely bleaching and then doing it. Now, in order to achieve this, I already had probably, you could say, a level 10, 11 blonde. And that's why this looks so light. I was on a 10, 11 blonde. Mainly 11, especially like up here. Definitely. So I went ahead and applied this all over my hair. I mixed them both together. And then I squeezed a whole lot of conditioner in it. And I mixed until it got to the perfect blue that I wanted. Now, that's the best part, is if you want it to be a little bit deeper or if you want it to be a little bit lighter, the best part is you're just adding conditioner to it so it's not damaging to your hair. So I mixed these two. I put it all over my hair. And what's great is kind of like a deep conditioning treatment to your hair. I went ahead and I pulled out my little hoodie. my heater, and I sat under that for 40 minutes. You don't have to do that, but to me, I feel like with the heat, it opens the pores of your hair, so it allows it to penetrate better. I've done it, like when I had the pink, I did it without heat, and I've done it with heat. Now, I just felt like the heat helps the color stick a little bit better and achieve the goal that I want to achieve. So after that, I just went ahead and I let it cool for a little bit. I let it cool for like 10 minutes and then I went and I rinsed my hair. Because I had already previously washed my hair prior to doing this, whenever I do stuff to my hair, I just like to do, like the night before, I'll do another mask treatment where I actually sleep with like a deep conditioning mask in my hair, and then I rinse it out in the morning and then let my hair air dry, and then I'll do whatever coloring that I'm gonna do to my hair. So I did that, and so I didn't have to wash it with shampoo. I just completely rinsed it out and just make sure I got out all of my conditioner. So this is actually the color it came out to be, which I do like it. In certain parts, because there was pink, there's like some like darker blues, as you can kind of see it in the camera. It's like purpley blues. That's kind of where the pink left over was from when I had my pink hair. This is pretty much what I did. I don't know, I'm kind of obsessed. It's growing on me. I kind of miss the pink, but I've gotten so many compliments on my hair, and my hair just feels so healthy, especially because of that. Anyways, so I hope you guys like the video. It's honestly just a fast forward of me going ahead and going through actually doing the color. So please give this video a thumbs up. If you haven't already subscribed, don't forget to subscribe. And until next time.
Said that we would always be. Without you, I feel lost at sea. Through the darkness, you'd hide with me. Like the wind, we'd be wild and free. You said you'd follow me, yeah.